the system has been actually for about the last 10 years a AV system, kind of semi-home theater. It's not surround because the wife doesn't want speakers all over the living room. But she's tolerated these pretty well, which I think is wonderful. The TV is a Mitsubishi 73-inch DLP. It has performed reliably for over 10 years, so I can't knock that at all. The rest of the system consists of an Oppo 203 Blu-ray player that's 4K capable. There's also some Behringer DCX2496 loudspeaker management system signal processors that can do crossovers, can do EQ, can do dynamic range limiting. As we saw in the 2 month ago presentation on doing an equalized loudspeaker, it can do it all for you, all in one box, except for the power amplification. I also have a third octave stereo equalizer there for just simply taking the unbalanced output of the TV or Oppo and changing it to balance, because everything in the rest of the system is XLR connectors. So I use that as a level shifter, unbalanced to balance converter, and doing a little bit of broadband EQ, you know, sweetening, so to speak. And the rest of the junk is downstairs from an amplifier system standpoint. I use four Behringer EP2500s for the power amps for the subwoofers and the woofers. Now, there's four woofers that you see here, but there's also four 18-inch diameter FICAR IB318 subwoofers located underneath what looks like a cold air return grate in the corner of the living room. This is a 1924s house. They had, you know, large duct heating systems back in that day in some of them, and that just looks like a cold air return or a heating grate. No, it's an infinite baffle subwoofer. We're sitting in the loudspeaker enclosure, or we're sitting over the other loudspeaker enclosure, part of it, to make it infinite baffle. The basement is 7-some feet high and 28 by 28-something. So you've got a bunch of cubic feet, and once you get beyond about 10 times the VAS of the speaker, it's considered more or less kind of sort of infinite, at least a closed box. The bigger you make it, the better it is. The other thing that if you have a soft suspension subwoofer, the resonant frequency, when you put it in an infinite baffle, the resonant frequency actually goes down. When I was using JBL 2245Hs, when I first put in the infinite baffle subwoofer system, the free air resonance was 20 hertz. Measured it, it was 20 hertz. Put it in the infinite baffle, it was 12.5 hertz. Talk about a rush. It just was wonderful. And that was with no EQ. Now, with a tighter suspension FICAR driver like what I'm using now, you ideally have to use some EQ with it. Anyway, with that said, if you have the FICARs, by the way, are 2 ohms per voice coil, because the EP2500s deliver 1200 watts into 2 ohms continuous with both channels running. That's the good news. The bad news is if you turn it up a little louder, it goes to actually put more power into each voice coil on a stereo power amp, and it blows the 15-amp breaker in the back of the Behringer EP2500. So to get around that, because these are 8-ohm, 12-inch woofers here tuned to about 60 hertz for the woofer system here in the living room, I use one channel of all four Behringers for the subwoofer voice coils and the other channel for the 8-ohm woofer voice coils. The Behringers are happy as clams. Works out wonderfully. I also use these, by the way, are JBL 2206H high power 600 watt, I hate to use wattage with speakers, 4-inch voice coil, high efficiency, and there's two of them here so that it more closely matches the efficiency of the mid-range, which is a 2-inch exit JBL 2445J 16-ohm voice coil, and that's another part of the rest of the story, with the 2380A JBL 90 by 40 horn, which is used on both sides here, you only get 113 dB 1-watt 1-meter sensitivity.
Only.
So I only run it with 150 watts, which is the limitation of the dissipation of the driver. You can get north of 128 dB SPL out of one of them. And there's two. Now, this little guy up here is affectionately known as the Baby Cheeks JBL Tweeter, the 2404H. It's an 8-ohm driver. It's a constant directivity horn like this is. It's a compression driver with the ring radiator like the old JBL 075 bullet tweeter, except they've taken the front of that tweeter off and put on this. And there's still the bullet in there, but it's the waveguide to channel it into the constant directivity horn. This is only, though, 105 dB 1 watt 1 meter. And with 40 watts, it gets you about up to 121-ish dB SPL. So can you reach the threshold of pain with any one of these? Absolutely. And it feels good. I use a Rain power amplifier, a Rain 6-channel that can be bridged. It's like 150 watts into 8 ohms, but if you, or no, 100 watts into 8 ohms, but if you use two channels and bridge them, you get 150 watts into 16 ohms. And since these are 16 ohm drivers, they're happy, the amplifier's happy, we're all happy, and we get nice, clean sound. Yes, Mark?
So Bob, that Rain device, it's the one with the fan in the back and the limiters, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and one nice thing about that unit is it works really well for tweeters because it won't let you go into clipping.
Right.
It'll actually limit in a
right.
very nice way, which is really good.
Yeah, so I use one of those Rain MA6S, which is the later version. There's six channels, a pair for this, a pair for that, and the other two for these two. So between five power amps, you have a full four-way loudspeaker system that crosses over from about 6 hertz to 60 hertz for the subwoofer, 60 hertz to 600 hertz for the woofers, 60 hertz to 6 kilohertz for the mid-range, and 6 kilohertz and up for the tweeter. The other thing is, with the Behringer DCX2496 loudspeaker management systems, you see these are mounted on the same front panel, but this really, the acoustic centers are different, but I can push this back time-wise in the loudspeaker management systems to align the acoustic centers of these speakers, and then align the acoustic center of this to those. Now, here's the other interesting thing. You know, we've all had geometry at some point, at time or another. And you know that the acoustic center of that, the acoustic center of that, and where your ear is, those two lengths are not equal. So I actually delay this compared to that so that it aims at your ear rather than at your stomach. And you gain more output cleanly by doing that. And the same thing with this to this and that to that. Any questions? Yes.
Do the Behringers do this with DSP, digital signal processing?
The 2496 means it's a 24-bit resolution, A to D
yeah.
processing, and then D to A with Shark analog devices processors used
yeah.
inside.
Okay.
High signal to noise ratio, balanced in and out, et cetera, you know, they're very, very good devices, and they've been used extensively, successfully. Any other questions? Thank you very much.
This program has been a production of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society. Opinions expressed during this program are those of the individual speaking and not necessarily the opinion of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society.